Madam Speaker, the Honourable Prime Minister, the Honourable Leader of the Opposition, Honourable Ministers, Honourable Members of Parliament. This morning I would like to make a statement on humanitarian assistance and disaster relief, HADR, in Fiji. There is no doubt, Madam Speaker, that this decade is branded and inscribed with increasing frequencies of natural disasters. A year on, after the aftershocks of the severity of tropical cyclone Winston is still visible. For the Minister of Defense, cyclones like the tropical cyclone Winston, flash floods, looming cyclones, anticipated earthquakes, and strong tidal waves are not only reshaping our topography, they are also remodeling the defense and security landscapes. Madam Speaker, it is for these compelling reasons, underscored by the threats of climate change on human security, that I wish to highlight the emerging importance of humanitarian assistance and disaster relief in national security. Madam Speaker, humanitarian assistance is a range of responses or actions in relation to sudden-onset emergencies. Emergencies in this regard are times when life-saving priorities come to the fore. Anticipating environmental emergencies like natural disasters sets the platform for preparedness. For our national security, this preparedness means being ready to protect human life and dignity and strengthening the capacity of the humanitarian community to effectively prepare for and respond to disasters. Madam Speaker, for 4 to 6 hours after the tropical cyclone Winston struck Fiji, military personnel responded. Vehicles drove through debris as military engineers began to make preliminary damage assessments. For many, our soldiers, sleeping beside rations, walking in disaster-torn sites, was the norm. Ill-equipped, they marched on. The first international team from Australia and New Zealand, their defense forces responded and arrived into the country within the first 12 hours. Given their geographical proximity to the islands of Lau, Tonga sent through a naval boat with rations to Vunombalabo. Defense force assets, including the HMAS Canberra, a landing helicopter dog ship, and the HMNZS Wellington, and HMNZS Canterbury proved to be necessary for surveillance and the delivery of humanitarian aid. International and national HADR medical assistance teams were also deployed to needed areas to provide medical assistance. Madam Speaker, soldiers distributed hygiene kits, tarpaulins, food, seeds, and medical supplies. 700 military personnel were deployed daily. For our strategic defense and national security planners, the realization sunk in that humanitarian action fit for the future is inevitable. Today, the RFMF is embarking on an innovative HADR plan which anticipates risks and challenges. The plan will coordinate and execute HADR activities at the strategic, operational, and technical levels to support national security interests as they pertain to natural disasters. The fundamental shift towards a model of humanitarian action that not only strengthens the response to crisis, but also learns and adapts to the evolving HADR environment is being mapped. The plan put in place by the commander will transform the 6 FIR to a dynamic team trained above the normal military training to respond during humanitarian crisis and disasters. Basic recruitment has been expanded to include engineering skills for all new recruits. The acquisition of the Bushmaster APCs is an added value to HADR efforts as these vehicles are made for rugged terrains. The expansion of the Black Rock Training Center in Nandi to accommodate increasing peacekeeping and HADR needs is in motion. We know that no other organization has the capability to respond with the speed and effectiveness that the military do in the immediate aftermath of any disaster. As first respondents, the military needs to be equipped and trained to deal with HADR necessities. Similar plans and restructure are currently underway within the Fiji Police Force HADR responses during flooding in Rakiraki, Ba, and the Western Division are testimony of required preparations for our security forces. The ultimate vision is that in the first hours after an environmental emergency, security forces will mobilize trained medical experts, engineers, respondents, and equipment, such as mobile hospitals, mobile desalination plants, and power tools to the affected areas. Often, HADR teams conduct rapid assessments and analyze the possible impacts on communities and help national authorities develop strategies to respond. To be effective, they need to be equipped. Madam Speaker, the international cooperation focus for defense has integrated HADR. In bilateral and multilateral dialogues, we have explored areas in which assistance and support can be tapped into the complement national initiatives. Similarly, Madam Speaker, Fiji's role in providing humanitarian assistance and disaster relief to the other Pacific Island countries is being carried out, like the cyclone Pam in Vanuatu 2015. Our soldiers were the first to arrive and do relief work. Despite the relatively positive perceptions on the HADR focus, there are areas we intend to improve, and we are working to prepare ourselves to the added responsibilities we are now tasked with. The scale and intensity of disasters requires the combined efforts of civilian and military organizations for effective response. We intend to leverage on the use of technology to enable better information sharing and build closer networks between civil and military players. Partnerships with international and development organizations like the UN, OCHA, Red Cross are critical to knowledge, capacity and expertise required for the enormous challenges at hand. In conclusion, Madam Speaker, I wish to again acknowledge and express our gratitude to the governments of Australia, New Zealand, France, Tonga and Papua New Guinea for the speed in which they responded to our HADR needs for the deployment of their defence assets. I also like to acknowledge the Minister for Regional Development, his Permanent Secretary and his team for the outstanding coordination role displayed during the rehabilitation phase of the tropical cyclone Wilson. There are many partners, Madam Speaker, to thank, and as our security forces engage to execute HADR plans, we hope the partnerships will be strengthened. Also, I'd like to take this opportunity to acknowledge the Fiji First Government leadership for its vision and direction. Thank you, Madam Speaker.